So today we're going to show you how to get the most out of your Elcat. This boat is so simple, it's so easy, super fun, but we know it's unique. This will go through all the little details and nuances to inflate the fun.
We all know that boats are very expensive to own, insure, tow, and maintain. Elcat is shockingly affordable when compared to anything else of its size or capability. Let's get this started. We'll show you why.
So a quick note about safety, the Elcat does have a nice safety warning label, and there are handles all over the place, and the handles are great for making you feel steady or secure. They're there for you when you're coming out of the water. The Elcat can get a little slippery when wet, so having these handles everywhere is super helpful. A life jacket. In this case, these are considered PFDs. You don't have to wear them, but you have to have them when you're out in the water, one for each person. Cordage. Always helpful to have whether you're trailing. You should have an anchor if you're worried about wind, depending on where you are. Some warmth, of course, and we recommend nothing cotton, because if you get wet, cotton doesn't do a whole lot. Finally, a means of communication, whether it's a marine radio or to make sure that you're gonna have cell service. Those are four critical things before you head off. Okay, so here's all the components to the Elcat and how it ships to you. You've got the floor, which includes the two cylindrical thwarts. This piece is at almost 80 pounds. You've got the two sides. These are each about 50 pounds. And then the roof, the transom, and the ladder. The motor ships separately, and that weighs about 55 pounds. There are 8 zippers on the Elcat. There's 2 for each side holding onto the floor, 4 for the floor. And there are 2 on each side of the roof, holds the roof to the sides. We actually make an Elcat model without zippers. What's nice about the zippers is that you can unzip the whole product and have it in separate components, so it's much smaller for transport. If that's not an issue and you have a pickup truck or a large van, you could save some money with the Elcat that does not zip up. And I want to give you a sense of how durable and strong these are. They're just like any other zipper, except mega scale. 15 feet long, 8 feet wide, 6.5 feet tall. This thing means business. Okay, so the Elcat comes with 2 pumps. One is an AC powered pump, high volume. It'll fill it up really quickly, but it doesn't quite have the pressure that the DC powered pump comes with. So this runs on 12 volt, the other one runs on 110 volt household power. And of course, all the inflating and deflating can be done with the GoSun Power 1100, an awesome lithium ion power bank. One thing that's really important to know is that the floor takes a higher pressure than the two rounded cylindrical elements. The cylindrical elements max out at around 3 PSI and the floor at around 6 PSI. Okay, we're gonna start with the floor, and these are a twist lock valve. So boom, I'm gonna put the power on. Incredibly high speed. It doesn't really matter the sequence of what channels you fill up first, but with the floor, you do want to stop inflating about halfway to install the transom, and this is where the motor is going to mount. So it slips into the floor via these little rubber grommets. It does take a little bit of unique finesse to get that all set up in there. And once those are loaded in, you can continue to inflate the floor. These valves will automatically lock. There's a setting for deflating where everything pours out, and there's a setting for lock. And it's in the lock setting that you want to inflate with. So deflate, inflate. Now we're done with the high volume AC powered pump. We're gonna move over to the 12 volt DC powered to get the flat parts, which there are 4 of, to get those to about 6 PSI. And what's cool on this guy is that you can literally set the pressure to automatically stop when you want. And I'll start with this wall here. Okay. So you can see how the pump automatically turns itself off. And then of course, it always is helpful to put the little valve cover on and you're ready for the water.
This is simply a cover and it is not designed to hold back air.
To set the ladder up, I just undid the nut and I'm gonna back off this big bolt, drop the ladder right where it belongs, run the all thread back through the boat, and then put the nut in on the other side. And that's it. This is, again, the swim ladder, so you can get in and out of the water super easily. It will hang out in the water when you're running about. So what I like to do, I like to strap the ladder up so that it's not an issue when running about. And there's a couple convenient spots to do this. That keeps it up and out of the water. All right, so here's the 3 horsepower e-propulsion Spirit Plus. Such a powerful and durable motor. First, just clip it onto the transom, and this is very intuitive. These compression locking bolts get the job done. You do want to give this some pretty good tension. So I'm gonna lower that, but first I'm gonna swivel it 180. This tiller arm comes up and locks, and then we're gonna swivel 180. We're gonna tilt it down with this stainless steel tab. This is a roughly 1.3 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery. It's actually set up to float. It's about 25 pounds, and you just wanna get it set up on the front there, slide the front end in, and bam, it's locked. I always like to test to make sure it's not going anywhere. And then finally, this is a beautiful waterproof connection. I've actually seen this motor get entirely deluged underwater and still perform. Just incredible engineering. Tighten that up, you're good to go. Now that we have the motor mounted, the next thing we're gonna do is get the solar system set up so that basically we can charge the battery while we're running about. And I'm gonna set up the 2 solar panels. The panels come with the necessary wiring harnesses. This is a coaxial. I'm gonna plug the output in. Okay, I'm gonna take that output from both panels and go into one of our combiners. So there's only one option. We'll do that from this one as well. And then finally from there, we connect it into the charge controller, and from the charge controller into the motor. I've got the extended output from the 2 panels, and I'm going to plug that into the charge controller. This charge controller box is extremely durable and capable of being left in the water. It's IP65 rated. A little bit of wire management. I like to keep the charge controller right here next to the transom. And then finally, I'm just gonna take the output from the panels and put it on the input of the battery. And with that, we're charging with the sun. Now this is gonna extend our range. When we're running about, we can just keep going and going and exploring. So we just showed you how to charge with the solar, and you can also charge with AC. This is a standard charger that comes with the battery, and it takes 6 hours or so, kind of overnight, to recharge. We have developed a little creative technique for moving the Elcat. These are little kayak trailers. So basically you just put one underneath each corner in the back, and then one person can tow the whole Elcat around. And then from the front, I can move the whole thing. And this is an example of just one person moving the Elcat. Something I love about the Elcat are these really rugged handles. There's 4 of them on the exterior, and there's 3 more on the inside. These are all great points for anchorage, for lifting, carrying, obviously, and they also kind of become bumpers when you're in docks. What's really cool is that they have a slot for your cordage, and this becomes a great point for anchorage, docking, towing, you name it. Elcat's electric motor is super simple, although it may take a minute to get used to. The throttle is a lot like a motorcycle. You twist it one way and go forward, and in the middle is neutral. Twist it the other way to go in reverse. For steering, you push the tiller to the right and the boat will go left, and the opposite is also true. Everybody
asks, you know, what kind of a range do you get? The answer is really based on how hard you're going, how many people you have, the headwind, the tides.
But something that's really interesting about this motor is that they give you a really clear readout of how you're doing. So this outer ring is your battery power. The hours there are how long you can run at the current speed. And then finally, down here, you're looking at the amount of power the motor is using in any given moment.
And you go much longer because, of course, we're GoSun, and you've got a solar-powered rooftop.
And there are six bladders. All you have to do is push this valve in once to release the air. It really doesn't matter the sequence that you use. I like to make sure that it all comes down in on itself in the process of deflating. Now that it's deflated also, I will be removing the transom. So you can see that the product will naturally deflate a bunch, but you don't actually want to like roll on this or lay on it yourself. You want to use the pump. So the same pump, instead of going out, you're gonna be going in. So basically you're gonna be running this in reverse. And so when all the air is sucked out, you can hear the pump change its tone. And that's when you know it's time to turn it off. So then we'll just repeat this process over the six different chambers to pull all the air out. So we're gonna try to make it as compact as we can today so that we have easy storage. We're getting ready to transport. And what we're going to do, we just deflated the Elcat. We're gonna fold it up and then roll it up. You want the zippers to be pretty close to the edge, maybe 6 inches or so here, not too far. The two sides are essentially coming together but not touching in the middle. In this mode, this is another great opportunity for cleaning and drying. I'm seeing areas where the Elcat has been touching the ground. At the front of the boat, not at the stern, but at the bow, I'm gonna start rolling the Elcat up. It does take a little bit of compression to get the first roll started. And there you have it, a rolled up Elcat. It's a lot easier with two people, but I'm just trying to demonstrate that one person can do it. And now it's just really a matter of leverage. So I'm just gonna lean it in rather than trying to lift it in. And it's that simple. So right now I have the air sucked out of the Elcat, and this isn't very good for long-term storage. When you're leaving it in your garage, you do want to leave these valves open, and we do recommend that you put a little bit of air in them.
You'll wanna avoid leaving creases in the product over long periods of time.
Boats are a huge pain to maintain, not so much with Elcat. One small thing that you may want to look at doing, this little key comes with your product. These valves can actually be a little loose upon your first use, just right to tight. This one's plenty tight. You can see what it looks like when it's loose. Really only have to do that at the very beginning. So before you wrap it up for storage, you want to put the product out in the sun and get it all nice and dry first. We found an awesome cleaning solution. Soap and water will do a great job as well. And all I'm doing is just wiping down all surfaces just to get all of our little smudges and footprints and things like that off. And then I'm just gonna let it dry. The Elcat is made of a super tough material. Double wall fabric of PVC. It's got the drop stitch on these big flat panels. But if, heaven forbid, you do end up finding a leak on your boat, you know, to find it, a little soap and water. Where you see bubbles coming out, you're gonna need to patch that. And there's a ton of information about patching inflatables on the internet. A two-part epoxy bond, and then the cleaner is this MEK. It does come with some PVC patches as well. I hope this how-to video was helpful. You can see how one person can set up the entire Elcat, a 15 foot long, 8 foot wide, 6.5 foot tall boat. It's huge. This thing will hold 6 people, 1,300 pounds. Really, it's surprisingly easy to do. We'll see you out on the water.